Thank you. So hello everyone, good morning, good evening from wherever you are based out. So this is Shrushti Shah and I'll be walking you through SharePoint syntax and mainly document understanding model, along with we'll also just go through Viva topics. So let me just go to the next slide. So first of all, I'd like to thank Alan for just walking me over and all the sponsors as mentioned. Thank you for giving me the chance to speak on this beautiful topic today. Apart from this, a short introduction about myself, just to give more time to the topic, I'll just keep it very short. So basically, I'm a developer and consultant by profession. And apart from that, I like to write. So I just have authored two books that is not technical books. And yes, I just also write technical blogs. So this is a short introduction about me. So let's get started. So basically SharePoint syntax, I'll walk you through a quick overview, like how you can enable SharePoint syntax for your tenant, how you can implement document understanding model, create models on top of your document libraries, and you can extract some of the data from it. Also, we look at what is Viva topics, just to give you an overview on it. And we'll definitely look at creating a Viva topic as well, and followed by a Q&A. So let me just walk you through a couple of slides and then we'll jump onto the demo screen as well so that I can walk you and you can better understand what exactly I'm speaking of. So syntax was the first product of Project Cortex, which Microsoft released during the last Microsoft Ignite, and it became generally available as mentioned on 1st October 2020. So what you can do is you can either buy a subscription or you can get a free 30-day trial just to try your hands on or play with what exactly SharePoint syntax is. And you can definitely, for just trying it, you have to activate SharePoint syntax for your tenant. So just let me skip this step right now and we'll look into how you can activate it. So basically when I say SharePoint syntax, so how you create models and where these models are stored in. So SharePoint syntax comes with a site called as Content Center site. This is a site which is created for you. You don't have to create for yourself. Once you just start activating, you just follow some steps, which is like while you activate your SharePoint syntax, then you will be at that time, a Content Center site will be created for you. As you can see on the screen, this is a site which has some graphs and some learning models on how you can get started with document understanding model. So basically from Content Center site, you can go ahead and create document understanding model. While there are other two types of models, which is form processing as well. So that you have to create it from any of your SharePoint library and you just have to, how you trigger Power Automate Flow in a similar way, you will have the option to create a form processing model right from your SharePoint library. No need of Content Center site for that. But yeah, in Content Center site, you will be seeing all your models placed here for your SharePoint syntax. So we look into this in detail as well. And this is a small just of what exactly document understanding model is. So basically we feed some data, which is in the form of documents. And these documents come in the form of, you have to add some positive data as well as some negative data. After adding your data, you have to explain the model that whether this is the correct document. For example, if I take a use case, which in my today's session I'm going to present, is contract processing model. So if I want my model to understand that whenever a document is added, this is the contract. So how will it understand? You will add some explanations so that model will understand whether this is a contract or not. And after making or classifying your documents, what is the purpose of using the model? You extract some data. So for example, from your contracts, sometimes you have to extract some important information like your contract date, your contractor, or the contract client name. So these are the information which you can extract by using extractor, and as well you have to give some explanations why, so that you, how your model will be able to extract the data for you. You don't have to manually do it anymore. So yes, this was just overview of document understanding model. So once you train your files, create a model, publish the model, then you can, you know, attach that model with your SharePoint document library, so that whenever you add some documents in there, your model will run in the backend, and it will classify, it will do the classification and extract the data for you. So this is what document understanding model is. And as I have mentioned that creating model, you can create this model using two ways. First is from content center side. You can go ahead and, as you can see, document understanding model, you can go ahead and create that way. Or if you come to your document understanding model models library, you can just create a model from here as well. So these are the two simple steps to create it. And what I was talking is, there are mainly four steps for your model creation. So basically you just add some sample files, you classify your files, and you create your extractors, as in you just want to fetch some data from it, and you just apply it to the library. So this is how it will look like. So the first step here is adding some training files. So as you can see, once you click on add files, you will be able to add some of the sample positive and negative data. And based on that, further we'll go ahead and classify it. So as the next step goes, which is classifier. So how you can classify it? So what first step was to add those files. So as you can see from the screenshot, I have added some sample files, and simply you have to label it as yes or no from your classifier, using your classifier. So if you label it yes, that means yes, this file is a contractor, and definitely you have to feed some negative files, so for which you will label it as no. So you can also go ahead and test here. So what you can do is, after just manually labeling this 5 to 6 or odd 10 files, then when you drop some odd files which you didn't add while you were training it, so then model, this classifier, will label it for you whether this is a contract or not. So this is how you train a model to classify it whether this is a contract or not. After classifying it, what we do is basically you just add some explanation. So just labeling doesn't give the correct results. Labeling might be wrong. There might be some similar files which might not be a contract. So you add some explanations so that your model is precise and it always gives accurate results. So this is how you can add. I'll walk you through this in the demo as well. So just giving a short introduction of how exactly you'll be doing it. So there are a couple of types of adding an explanation. So it can be a phrase list, it can be a date, it can be anything. So we just look at it. An extractor, as I mentioned, you can extract important information. So from your contract, for example, I want to extract client name. So I'll give explanations for each of my file at the starting, and then I'll be adding my model to a library so that next time my model does the work for me. So as you can see, once your model is attached to a library, you will be able to see this icon into a library, which is an information icon tooltip. So basically what does is, for each, this is just to differentiate between your normal document library and your library which is, you know, classified one. So this will give the information or indication that this library is attached with a model, so it is a classified library. So let me just walk you through document understanding model first, and then we'll just look at Viva topics. So let me just walk you through first how you can, you know. So as you can see, I have come to my admin center, and you just have to go to the setup. So whenever you will purchase the resources, like you have to purchase Shipments and tax. After you purchase or you avail for 30 days license, you just come to set up. In your files and content, you will be seeing these two options. So automate content understanding is for SharePoint syntax, and connect people to knowledge is for your Viva topics. So let me just go to automate content understanding. So this is a beautiful screen wherein you can just go ahead and quickly glance through the details of what automate content understanding is, so that users can create the AI models and they can extract the data, which is for document understanding model. Apart from this, you can just glance through which are the type of models you can create. As you can see, image tagging, form processing, document understanding, and PAP. And from the Power Platform admin, you can just create a number of other AI builder models as well. So let me just quickly go ahead. From here, you'll be able to manage your SharePoint syntax settings. So we'll just quickly see that. And you can also go through this documentation for your future use, so that you can know very well that how you can, you know, classify and extract the data. So as you can see, I just came from my SharePoint syntax settings and it landed me to a content center site. So this is a site which I was showing, and here you can see I can create the document understanding model. This is the option. This is a quick tour of how you can create. You can just go and take this tour, and here you can see the graphs, also the models which I have created. And just to you, if you click on see all, it will land me to the models page. Let me just go to this models and we'll quickly see. Okay, so these are the models which I had created, and also you can add your training files, which I was just talking about right from here. So these are the sample contracts which I have created. These are the positive files and these are some negative files. So you can also go ahead and upload some more files here, but for of now, I've just added 5 positive per items and 1 negative document. So what I'll do is I'll quickly go to, you know, models and create, just let me show it to you how you can do this. Okay, so this is how your models page will look like. You can just go to model setting to know what exactly your model is about. You can check the description. Also, you can take a tour of your model page as well. And the same training files you can check here. Also, you can add files from here. So now, after adding some files, what are we going to do is, this is just this part. You don't have to do anything. You just have to add sample files with positive and negative documents. After taking this step, just let us come to classifier option. So now you can see I have added some files here. So these are some positive contracts and some negative files, which are documents which are not contracts at all. So what I'll be basically doing is, for each file, for example, let me come to sample contract. And for this file, I am labeling it as yes. Let me just go to the, for this file, this is not a contract, no. So as you can see, as I am labeling yes or no to my files, here you will be able to see those labels which you would have labeled. And apart from that, once I come to my contracts, I have tagged it as yes, just no. Okay, so once you complete doing this, you can add more example files. You go to training step. After going to training step, what you will be doing is you will be giving some explanation, right? So what explanation you'll be giving? So that this explanation will be given to the model, so that whenever a file is added, your model will understand that, okay, this thing is present in this file. That is why it is a contract. So that is what an explanation is about. So as you can see here, this is an explanation pane wherein you can go ahead and add a blank explanation or explanation from out of the box template. So as you can see, templates are of different types here. You can just go ahead, use a phrase list wherein you can add multiple options or multiple phrases. You can add currency, date. Date has different formats. In this format, you can add You can add email, date, email greeting, recipients, and many more other out-of-the-box options. So right now, what I did is I come to my this file. And from this file, I always see that some of the names make it unique, like makes my contract unique. So that is why I have added an explanation called as contract, in which I have added some phrases called as contractor, contract, contract between. These are the phrases which I will always find in my contract. If I don't find it, then that is not a contract. So to make it more precise from looking through my documents, I have just enabled this, checked this only exact capitalization. If you don't opt for this or don't check it, then too it is fine. Also, you can see where these phrases will occur. So if you want to restrict it more, that only in the top section of your file, only at the bottom section, which is end of the file, beginning of the file, or any range. So that is, you can always restrict it as well. So it is like, maybe there are a few other files which might not be a contract, but they might have some similar words. So you restrict it more and more so that to get accurate results. So once you save and train, it will try to look for those phrases in each of the document and then evaluate it. Unless you get everything as matched, you can't go ahead. So it is must to get a match for each of the result type so that you know that your explanation is correct. Otherwise, you have to add more explanations, more types, so that you just train your classifier. So this is how you classify your documents and you train your classifier. So let's just go back to, then yeah, definitely you can go ahead and test it as well by giving some files and you will be able to see the label as well. So let me just exit this training and come to, so the next step is, now what we did is we made our model to understand that yeah, this file which I have added is a contract now because it matches with some of the explanation, right? But after matching those explanations, I want to get some data from my contract. So how will I do that? So let me just go ahead and go to extractor. So as you can see, you can create a new extractor. Also, you can create a new column for it. So what this does is, whenever you create an extractor, it will create a new column for you into your SharePoint document library. So this will always create a column. But when you attach this model with your library, this will be, this extractor column will be added in that when you create extractor, it asks whether you want to create a new column or you want to add an existing one. So you can do that. Also, you can have a column type of any of these five types. So let me just go ahead and see. This is the contractor name which I'm trying to extract from here. So this is the same window which we saw for classifier. Exactly same, you'll label, you'll train, you'll test. So for labeling, what we are doing is, now we are not labeling it as yes or no, but we are labeling the exact data which we want to fetch. So as you can see from my this so-and-so company, I am highlighting. So what you basically do is, just let me cancel this. For this contract, I come and I see, oh yeah, this is my client name. So I'm just highlighting it. So this highlighted phrase is my client name for this file. You can have multiple highlights as well. You come ahead, you highlight for each of the file, and for files which are not contracts, you just tag it as no label. So let me just quickly do this. These are my sample files, negative files, which are not contract. So I'll quickly label it as no. Okay. So after labeling each and every document, as you can see, you will be able to see no labels. And for the contracts, we'll be seeing those client names, which you just highlighted. After doing this, again, you come to the training section. In the training section, yeah. So similar thing what we did for classifier, what we are going to do is to extract this value in future, like while I'm doing it manually, I have to, you know, write it or see each of the file and then update this similar data into my document library. But what right now we are doing is we are training our model to do the same thing. So for this contract, what we are going to do is we are going to give explanation to our model so that it will extract the perfect client value. So how will you do that? So as we see in the explanation, we have got something called as prefix or suffix, which is called as before label and after label in this. So you use those explanations. So what we'll do is, this is prefix. And what I did is, this is my client name, as you can see, which I have highlighted. So for every client name, this thing is common for me, for my documents or for my contracts. So what I did is, I just wanted to match and give this explanation that whenever I see this in prefix, this is just a one explanation. So if you just add this and save and train, there is a possibility that not every document will get match. So what we did is, also you can give suffix saying that after each, this is the prefix, but if you find suffix like this, then just extract that particular value. So after doing this, adding this explanation, what we'll do is we'll train it. So let me just quickly train this model and let's see if it fetches the correct result or not. So as you can see, all the files got a perfect match, which means my model is 100% accurate, as you can see. And you can also go ahead and test this simultaneously, similar to what we were doing for classifier. Now coming back to our model page, once you have classified, once you know what you want to extract, then the last step is you just want to apply this model to your library. So once you click on applying to a model, you just have some of the sites. You can just quickly go to any of the site and attach it with the any of your document library. What you can do is you can also create one new. So right now I have already attached, as you can see, this thing here will always get you that which all libraries you have attached with this model. So right now, this is my normal document library, but the only difference, as you can see, is this thing. This is what I was pointing out. So what it state is, this tooltip will always be there for your classified document libraries, and this will indicate a user, SharePoint author or any user, that this library is been classified using so and so models. And you can also go ahead and check out which is the active model right now being attached to this library. And also you can give some sensitive labels, which is retention label, so that you always have secured value. So as you can see, the description of my label, everything right from here. You can also go ahead and switch your library view, manage the model. Once you click on managing your model, it will take you to this model page which you were looking out for. So this is how beautifully you can just connect your models with your library. And once you drop in your files here, you'll be able to see the content types, contractor names, and the score. Right now what you see is a view which model is created for you. So let me just quickly go. Yeah, so right now these are different type of views, and this view you can edit the current view and you'll see the different. And right now what you see is contractor name, and this was the extractor which we created, and it got created as a column. So this is what extractors do. It will create a column for you whenever you will attach it to a library. So in the view you can see all the content type, contractor name, and also the score, so that to understand whether this model is accurate or not. So this view also gets created with it. And there's one more thing, you can also just select any of the file. So what happens is, unless you drop in your files, your model won't run, right? If you have some previous data, you want to classify those. So what SharePoint Syntax bot is, you can just select those files and run this classify and extract button here, so that it will run for all the three file types, and it will show the status here as well. So this is how you can also train your files which have been added into this library previously. So this is how document understanding model works. Apart from this, let me just quickly go back. Yep. So let me just come back to another topic, which is we quickly look into Viva topics. So basically, what Viva topics just highlights your content. It will help other users to know what is the content behind some acronyms, or you can find some topics in your SharePoint search as well. As you can see, these are the suggestions which you'll get into your SharePoint search. You can connect with people of same knowledge. This is a part of Viva, which recently got released. So employee experience, Viva connections, Viva topics. So this Viva topics is a part of Viva employee experience. And this will always, this will create a network for you wherein you can just find the right information and connect with the right people. So this is just small overview of Viva topics. And exactly Viva topics is in terms of, you know, SharePoint, we can say is topics are pages, and you just create those pages called as topic pages. You can give some information about your topic. So for example, if there is a project called Venus, so what exactly Venus is, if some new joiner comes in, they don't know what Venus is. So if they just go ahead, search in SharePoint search, they'll be knowing that Venus is some sort of project which is run by some different team. So this all things, this data is created by you, by a people, and they can connect with those right people. They can get the right information from that topic. That is what Viva topic is. So topics are created as well as topics needs to be managed. So there are four different stages of Viva topics you can manage, which is a suggested topic, which suggested topics, confirmed topics, topics which are published, and topics which are removed. So basically, suggested topics are the topics which are, you know, discovered by your AI itself. So you don't have to do anything in that. But the topics which are confirmed is some user or some, if you can say moderator, they go ahead and check for the topics and they find that, okay, this topic is valid. Only then they can confirm. Once the topics are confirmed, only then they are published. So these things are done by some user moderator or some other XYZ person who are managing this Viva topics page. And if the topic is not relevant right now, if for example, some projects are declined or some projects don't work right now, so you can just go ahead and delete those topics so that in future it doesn't come up into a SharePoint search. So these are the four different phases of topics which you can manage. Apart from that, let's just go and okay. So what I'll be doing is similarly what we'll do. We'll just quickly check Viva topics setup. So this both syntax, Viva topics, this setup guide will always look same. So you can always find more description from Viva topics Microsoft documentation. Also, you can navigate. So just like how we had Content Center site to manage our models, you will have a topic center site to manage your topic pages. So it is almost likely similar. You can also learn more about Viva topics by going into it. As I said, it will highlight the interested subject of your project or of your topic. And you can also display a topic in form of topic card. So that how we have a contact card. So similarly, topics will have a card wherein whenever you come across the topic and you'll hover over it, you will be seeing all those information, whatever you have, feed in your topic page. So topic pages, as I mentioned, is a full view of a topic wherein you can go ahead, add some details or description about it, add some relevant contacts or people information, and also some detailed files and documents related to that topic. And yeah, you can map that topic with another topic as well, so that the user understands that these two things are related with each other. So yep, let's just go ahead and navigate to the topic center site. Yeah, so right now what you see is a topic center homepage. As I mentioned, there were four phases of managing the topics. So only the confirmed or published ones looks like this. So this is my card, which I was mentioning about. So let's just go ahead. And there are two ways of creating a topic as well. So this is how you'll create a topic page, or you just go ahead and go to the pages. This is the pages library, and here you'll be seeing a topic page. So previous, like this is a topic center site. That is the only reason you are seeing a topic page. But if you go to your normal communication or team site, you won't be able to see this. So for this as well, you have to purchase a license, or you can avail for free trial as well. So let's just go and quickly check if we can find some topics and we can edit the same. So as you can see, this is how a topic page will look like. Let me edit this one because I haven't added more information on it. So this is the topic page. So this will always be what is your topic acronym. So if you have some different acronyms like Saturn, Venus, or Mars, you can just add here. If you want to give some detailed information of that acronym, that what exactly that topic is about, you can give some explanation. You can give detailed description on that summarizing of your topic. You can add people so that the user who will search for this in future or who will be part of this topic later on, they might know that who all are the people who works with and who they can contact in future. You can also add files, just like your document library. You can add some related sites. For example, if you have some sites which are related to this major topic, you can add those simply just by adding those topics. Also, what I was mentioning is you can add some related topics. For example, Mars and Venus are related. So how I can add is just have to go and add some topic here. So right now I don't have another topic created. So if you have, you can go ahead and just check this out, and you can add those and you can connect those topics as well. So this is how your topic page will look like. And once you publish, just discard those change. This is how your topic page will look. And for the home page, what you see is this is a topic card. So once you hover over, whenever some user adds this EVR in their pages or normal pages, so that whenever they'll hover, they'll be seeing these all activities and all the data of EVR. Now what we can do is we can go to manage topics. So as I was mentioning, just give me a minute. Just refresh this page. Yeah. So from your manage topics page, you will be able to see all these four stages: suggested, confirmed, published, and removed. So what I will do is I just remove this, and now I'm able to see here. So for example, this is what I mentioned: some users or some moderators will manage these topics. So for them, they will be seeing. So suggested topics are, you can just go to the tooltip and it will notify you what this is about. But basically, suggested topic is what AI will suggest. So these are the suggestions which AI will bring for you, and then it is the moderator's work so that they'll be confirming it and publishing it for on your behalf, or removing it if it is of no use. Also, you can create a topic page from managed topics as well. So this is what we were looking into. So this is how simple your Viva topics you can create. You can play with it, you can add it and try it and check how your topic cards look like. So yeah, this was about Viva topics, a short overview. So this sums up everything about document understanding model, Viva topics. And before just wrapping it up, Microsoft 365 Chicago is basically, you know, running this donation for a good intention. So you can just go ahead and quickly, you know, if someone wants to donate something, you can go and follow this link, or you can do the same. And yep, you can provide the feedback as well. So just wrapping it up, I am just welcome to the questions, so I can take up if anyone has any questions.
That was great. I haven't seen any questions go into the chat, so if anybody wants to put their hand up and ask a question, please do. I guess you've covered off all of the questions then. Yeah, thank you. That was great.
Thank you for having me, Alan. Thanks all for listening to me. You can always reach out to me if you have any questions later on.
So there's one question that's gone in, which is about the trial. Is there a trial for topics and syntax?
Yeah, there is trial for both SharePoint syntax and for Viva topics as well, which is 30 days. So you can go ahead and you can just try it out from your Microsoft 365 Admin Center. You can purchase, like you have to go to the purchases section and you can just find it there as well. And you can just start your free trial then.
Excellent, thank you. So Greg, hopefully that answers your question. Oh, and can you add it to a dev tenant?
Yep.
Simple and succinct answer.
Yes, you can add it to the dev tenant as well.
As a trial.
Yeah.
Yeah. Excellent. Well, thank you very much. I'll stop the recording now.
Thank you. It was great having you. Thank you.